Hello Internet, welcome to the 6th video of technical analysis tutorial series. My name is Nurpin and in this video we will take a look on momentum indicators. Momentum means same thing in technical analysis as in physics. In physics, momentum is used to calculate the rate at which velocity changes. In technical analysis too, it is used to calculate the rate at which price changes. Momentum is a leading indicator. A leading indicator is an indicator which signals change in direction before price actually changes direction. It should be noted that change in momentum doesn't guarantee change in price. Still, momentum indicators are most trusted form of indicators in technical analysis. There are two bases on which you can classify momentums. First, either they are range bound or not. Second, how many variables of price were used to calculate them. For example, relative strength index, also known as RSI, is range bound indicator because its value always remains bounded between 0 and 100, whereas absolute rate of change doesn't have any range. Also, RSI and ROCA are calculated based on single price variable, the closing price. Same doesn't apply to indicators like MACD and stochastics, where highs, lows, opening price and moving averages are also taken into consideration. Momentum indicators where more than one price variable is taken into consideration always clearly display oscillating property of price and hence are also known as momentum oscillators. Thus, there are two types of momentum indicators. First is price strength indicator, in which while calculation only one price variable is used. They just reflect strength and weakness in direction of price. And the second is momentum oscillator, in which more than one price variable is used to calculate momentum and it exhibits oscillating property of price. Due to its ability of mapping price cycle, momentum oscillators are also known as price cycle indicators. In spite of the fact both price strength indicator and momentum oscillators measure momentum, they represent momentum in different way. For finding good buy or sell signals, the very first thing that you should check is price strength and then price cycle. Hence, your chart setup should include both strength and price cycle indicators. Rate of change and relative strength index are most popularly used strength indicators, whereas stochastics, MACD and KST are most popularly used price cycle indicators. Now we will take a look on few characteristics of momentum indicators that are absolutely necessary for successful momentum analysis. First is time span selection. Almost all indicators are tested with different values and the values that worked with majority is kept as default. In most cases, you will never have to change default values, but in technical analysis, there is no such thing as default. Values has to be adjusted to get maximum consistency on signals. If you don't like adjusting values, then better stick with RSI as strength indicator and MACD as price cycle indicator. They hardly need any adjustments. Now, oversold and overbought levels. Concept of overbought and oversold is one of the most important concepts for properly using momentum or finding better entry and exit points. It is often highly misinterpreted and misunderstood, so please listen carefully. Overbought is level where probabilities favor that selling might start, but by no means it's a guarantee that stock will start falling in price. Majority of the times selling actually starts, but price don't fall down. Selling is usually associated with fall in prices and hence most think overbought means signal to sell, which is quite wrong. If sellers start selling and buyers start accumulating, then by no means stock will fall in price in spite of heavy selling. Same applies to oversold level. It is level where odds favor heavy buying, but it doesn't mean guaranteed profitable buy signal. In range bound indicators like stochastics and RSI, you have fixed range for overbought and oversold level. Same doesn't apply to non-range bound indicators like ROC and MACD. For non-range bound indicators, you have to find and draw overbought and oversold lines yourself. There are no hard and fast rules to draw oversold and overbought lines. This can be determined only by studying history of security and knowledge of different momentum concepts. Price cycle indicators have signal lines to confirm change in price cycle, but price strength indicators don't have such signal lines to confirm shift in price momentum. So an EMA is drawn over them to get confirmation on momentum shift. This EMA is known as smoother line. Price strength indicator crossing smoother line doesn't guarantee change in momentum. It just confirms weakness in current price strength. Now divergences. Divergences occur when the rate at which price changes slows down. It actually shows weakness in current trend. During downtrend, we say bullish divergence occurred when prices keep falling but momentum starts recovering. Bullish divergence usually marks slowing down of bearishness. A confirmation is always required. During uptrend, we say bearish divergence occurred when prices keep rising but momentum starts falling. Clean and unclean are two types of divergences. A clean divergence is the one where divergence is clearly visible. The unclean ones are those where you find yourself in confusion either divergence happened or not. For example, look the chart on screen where you can see price went up but momentum went almost no change. This kind of scenario is very confusing. In second example, second low was lower than first low. This applies to both price and momentum. But when price made third low, that low was higher than second low but lower than first low. And if we compare momentum between first and third low, divergence is clearly visible. Identifying divergences is very important part for any momentum analysis. If you get divergence wrong, most probably you will get everything wrong about momentum analysis. Just for practice, I would advise you to look at chart analysis that I do on regular basis on my channel. It will help you understand how to handle complicated divergences. For now, keep in mind, divergences only warn weakening of current trend. Confirmation is always required. As general rule, the more number of divergences, the more strong and profitable will be the reversal. And just like any other technical analysis tool, it is susceptible to failure, but is most trusted among almost every technical analyst of the world. Next is change in range. All momentum indicators, either it be price strength indicator or momentum oscillator, undergo change in range during bull and bear times. There is no such thing as standard range for any momentum indicator. For example, many consider RSI touching 30 is buy signal, whereas RSI touching 70 is sell signal, which is 100% wrong. Look this chart of ICICI Bank. When it was in uptrend, RSI never touched 30 once. Oversold level was always above 30 and even overbought was above 70. During downtrend, it changed. Overbought never touched 70, whereas oversold always went below 30. Don't fool yourself thinking there is always a fixed range. Momentum indicators also respond to trend lines and patterns as prices react to them, which means if you find head and shoulder pattern on momentum indicator, then it will increase chances of fall in spite of the fact no head and shoulder pattern is actually formed over price. Now sensitivity in bull and bear market. During bull market, momentum might shift to overbought condition very quickly and stay there for a long time. In bear market, it can and it too remain in oversold condition for a long time. In bull market, price is extremely sensitive to oversold condition, which means momentum can shift to oversold level without price undergoing any major change. Opposite will happen in bear market, where prices may touch overbought without any major recovery in price. You should always draw trend lines to take advantage of this sensitivity, because as soon as trend line breaks, prices usually continue in direction of trend sensitivity. Now identifying weaknesses. To use momentum properly, first you have to find weakness in momentum. Weakness means divergence, price pattern or sensitivity. Second, you have to get confirmation that momentum has finally changed. You can get it by seeing is there a crossover between price strength indicator and smoother. If you see crossover, then check is price cycle indicator showing any signs of new price cycle. If yes, then does that cycle matches direction of recently changed price strength. Finally, you take price confirmation by using a trend following indicator to make buy or sell decision. Just like any other indicator, momentum is also susceptible to failures. A momentum indicator assumes price is moving in cycles and most stocks actually exhibit cyclic movement. But if cyclic movement is totally absent, like in stocks moving in linear regression, momentum indicators are practically of no use there. They also can't give better buy and sell signals on stocks that are moving sideways. I think we should limit this here since video is becoming too long. In next video, we will see how to use RSI. Till then, thanks for watching and have a nice day.